welcome to the ITU Plenipotentiary Conference 2022 here in Bucharest, Romania. We've got the great pleasure of being joined in the studio today by Tariq Alamri, who is the chair of the Radio Regulations Board for ITU. Tariq, welcome to the studio.
Thank you. My pleasure, Max. Thank you.
Now, we're going to take this opportunity to talk about the Radio Regulations Board, RRB, as it's known for short, and about its role and also its composition.
Yeah, the Radio Regulation Board is a vital body within the ITU structure. As you know, that ITU is divided into three main sectors: the radio communication sector, the standardization, and the development. The board plays a key role in achieving, let me say, the main objective of the radio communication sector, which is the global management of radio spectrum resources and orbital resources. Really, the board is, as I said, plays a key role in this area to ensure efficient use of the spectrum, but at the same time to ensure the interference-free operation by all radio communication service, by all member states at international level. Really, the board in performing its duty through the implementation of the radio regulations. The radio regulation is one of the ITU instruments that complement the ITU basic text, the constitution and the convention. The radio regulation is one of the international binding treaties for all member states. It governs the use of the radio spectrum and orbital resources with respect to the use by all member states, but at the same time, it defines the rights and obligation by all member states in using these resources. So it is a very important treaty, and also one thing interesting about this treaty that it is evolving with time. It is not like other compared to other treaties. As you know, at each WRC that this treaty is reviewed and revised to allow deployment of new technologies in different radio communication service, but at the same time ensure protection of the existing service. This is, let me say, this is the, in brief, the role of the BR, the Radio Regulation Board. Related to your question about the structure of the board, the board composed of 12 elected members, expert in the field of radio communication and spectrum management. They are representing 5 geographical regions, and they are elected at the Plenipotentiary Conference together with the senior management team, together with the ITU Council member state. As I said, they are elected during the Plenipotentiary Conference for 4-year term. This is related to the structure. Regarding the chair and the vice chair of the board, they are elected by the board members on annual basis. The chair and vice chair, the board members elect their chair on annual basis for each year, yes.
Excellent. And now you've been with the RRB for a number of years now. Perhaps you could tell us a little bit about its mandate and also the way the decisions are taken.
Yeah, the mandate of the and duties of the Radio Regulation Board is contained in the Constitution and Convention and Radio Regulations, which include approving the rule of procedure, which complement the radio regulation provisions, and also considering appeals against Radio Communication Bureau decision. We also consider case of non-resolved harmful interference, and we provide recommendation to resolve those cases. And also the board provide recommendation to different ITU conference like the WRC Radio Assembly and also for the Plenipotentiary Conference. And also the board consider cases which cannot be resolved by the existing radio regulation provisions, and we are taking decision regarding them. This is related to the mandate. Regarding your question about how the board takes its decision, the decision of the board is taken according to the working method in the convention of the ITU. Let me say, most of the decision of the board are taken by consensus by all board members. But if there is any case that the board cannot reach this consensus, there is approach to, let me say, to take, which is no decision can be valid by the board unless 2/3 of the board member vote in favor of that decision. this is, let me say, if there is no consensus, but according to my memory, all of the decision taken by the board by consensus, yes.
Excellent. And you mentioned feeding into the work of the Plenipotentiary Conference. Perhaps you could tell us a little bit about what's been happening here at PP22 of the work of the RRB here.
Yeah, as I said, one of the duties of the board that it is provide recommendation for different IT conference. So we are participating in the Plenipotentiary Conference with advisory capacity. Two board members designated by the board, me and my distinguished colleagues, Madame Lilian from Netherlands. We are representing the Radio Regulation Board at this Plenipotentiary Conference. We are really following the issues with radio-related aspect that it is related to the radio. Most of them really related to the space services. We have participated in the development of the new resolution related to the Article 48 of the Constitution, which, let me say, extend the mandate of the boards to so they can have the authority to deal with the cases where Article 48 invoked. And we have also involved in the discussion related to the modification of Resolution 119, which is related to the methods and to improve the efficiency and effectiveness of the RRB. Also, the board highlighted its effort when related to the resolution related to the space sustainability. We highlighted our current efforts really in that area and our plan to include this important issue about the space sustainability in our report, which will be submitted to the next WRC, WRC 2023. We also enclose monitoring with different issues related to the space, for example, the ITU role in the implementation of the Space Agenda 2030, and also the confidence building measure in outer space activities. This is, let me say, a brief our role, our issue of interest at this Plenipotentiary Conference, yes.
Excellent. WRC 2023, which is taking place in Dubai next year. It's going to be a very busy time, I'm sure, for RRB and for the rest of the radio communication sector. But thank you very much for joining us in the studio today.
Thank you. I want to take this opportunity. As you know, by the end of this year, my role will end as a board member. It was really a great honor for me serving ITU as elected board member for the last 4 years and as elected chair for the current year. I want to thank the ITU for recognizing my contribution to support of the ITU activities. I want to thank all member states for their trust in me, with a special thanks to the Arab Regional Group, really. I want also to express my sincere gratitude and appreciation to the government of Kingdom Saudi Arabia, Ministry of Communication and Information Technology, Communication and Information Technology, for all empowerment and support provided to me to fulfill my duties. With full respect to my status as a board member, I want to thank my colleague, distinguished board member, for their spirit of cooperation, commitment, which had enabled us to take a decision for difficult issues, really. Last but not least, I want to thank my family, really. I know I have created a lot of trouble for them because of my repeated absence. I am really so grateful for their patience. Thank you, Max.
Thank you. Well, thank you for sharing all those words with us and those valuable insights, and wish you all the best for the future. Thanks so much indeed.
Thank you.